we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section algebra, and the problem is on the famous Fermat's last theorem of number theory, and this question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section C. Before, you know, stating the problem, now we talk about its prelude, the prelude of the Fermat's last theorem. What is Fermat's last theorem today known as? It is known as, no three positive integers x, y and z satisfy the equation x power n plus y power n is equal to z power n for any integer n greater than 2. That means there does not exist natural numbers x, y, z satisfying x power n plus y power n is equal to z power n for integers, for positive integers n greater than 2. The above statement was proposed by Fermat in 1637 in the form of a scribbled margin. That means he has scribbled in the margin of a book, in the form of a scribbled margin of his copy of the ancient Greek text Arithmetica by Diophantus. So he is scribbled in the margin of the copy of the book entitled Arithmetica, written by Diophantus. At the end, Fermat said, "I have discovered a truly marvelous demonstration of this proposition that this margin is too narrow to contain." He claimed that he has a marvelous proof for the above statement. But later, Fermat did not publish any proof for his claim. This proposition resisted proof, and as a result, it remained as a conjecture over 350 years. It is now proved by Andrew Wiles in 1995, and thus Fermat's conjecture is now known as the Fermat's last theorem, and it is a famous theorem in number theory. Let's now get into the problem. The problem that is given in the examination is, let n be the set of positive integers. For n belongs to n, the set of natural numbers, let a suffix n is equal to the set of ordered pairs x, y, z belongs to n cube, such that x power n plus y power n is equal to z power n and z less than n. Let capital F of n be the cardinality of the set A suffix n. Which of the following statements are true? We are given four options. Option 1, F of n is always finite for n greater than or equal to 3. And option 2, F of 2 is equal to infinity. Option 3, F of n is equal to 0 for all n. Option 4, F of n is non-zero for some n greater than 2. Let's now discuss the solution of the problem in detail. We have the set of natural numbers. For any n belongs to n, we have a suffix n defined like this. that is the set of all ordered triples x comma y comma z belongs to n cube, satisfying x power n plus y power n is equal to z power n and z less than n, and f of n is the cardinality of a n. Now we consider three cases. The case 1, let n is equal to 1, then A1 will be set of all ordered triples x comma y comma z belongs to n cube, such that x plus y plus z and z less than 1 by the definition of a n. Agreed. Now A1 is an empty set. Why? Because there is no natural number z such that z less than 1. So therefore A1 is empty. Therefore f of 1, that is the cardinality of A1, is 0 because A1 is empty. Okay. Option 2. Let n is equal to 2. Then A2 is the set of all ordered triples x comma y comma z belongs to n cube, such that x square plus y square is equal to z square, and z less than 2, that is equal to, z less than 2 means z is equal to 1 only because z belongs to n. So it is the set of all ordered triples x comma y comma 1 belongs to n cube, satisfying x square plus y square is equal to 1. Do we have two natural numbers x, y such that x square plus y square is equal to 1? There are no two natural numbers x and y satisfying x square plus y square is equal to 1. Now A2 is empty since there does not exist natural numbers x comma y such that x square plus y square is equal to 1. Therefore f of 2, the cardinality of A2, is 0 since A2 is empty. So now in the option 2, it is given f of 2 is equal to infinity, and therefore the option 2 is not true. Why? Because f of 2, we have shown it to be equal to 0. Thus, the option 2 is not true. We continue in the next slide. We have this. Let's go for the case 3. Let n be a natural number and n greater than 2. Now we recall Fermat's last theorem. It states no three positive integers x, y and z satisfy this equation x power n plus y power n is equal to z power n for any integer n greater than 2. By this FLT, the Fermat's last theorem, we do not have natural numbers. We do not have natural numbers x, y, z satisfying this for n greater than 2. N belongs to n greater than 2. So this an will be empty. So therefore an is equal to the set of all ordered triples x comma y comma z belongs to n cube, satisfying x power n plus y power n equal to z power n, and z less than n is equal to, is empty set for n greater than 2, because we do not have natural numbers x, y, z satisfying this one. And mind you, in this assertion, that is an is empty, z less than n we have not used, and z less than n we have used in case 1 and case 2. By Fermat's last theorem, an is empty for n greater than 2. Therefore, f of n is the cardinality of an is equal to 0 because an is empty for n greater than 2. So, f of n is 0 for n greater than 2. So, now combining all the three above cases, an is empty and f of n is cardinality of an is 0 for all n belongs to n. Now, we recall the options. Now, in this options, option 3 says f of n is equal to 0 for all n, which is true now by this. And when f of n is equal to 0 for all n, certainly f of n is always finite. for n greater than or equal to 3. For n greater than or equal to 3, f of n is also 0. 0 is a finite quantity. Therefore, f of n is always finite for n greater than or equal to 3. Therefore, the options 1 and 3 are true. And f of n is non-zero for some n greater than 2 is false. Is not true. Is not true. Why? Because f of n is 0 for all n belongs to n. Therefore, f of n is non-zero for some n greater than 2 is not true. So, by this argument, the options 1 and 3 are true and the option 4 is not true. So, thus we have proved the options 1 and 3 are true and option 2 and option 4 are not true. Our final answer is the options 1 and 3 are true. So, that is the discussion of the solution of the problem based on Fermat's last theorem. I am sure you have understood the solution of this problem and go on working out some more problems on these lines from number theory section of algebra. I wish you all the best. Thank you.